Hey guys, Brain here, and let's talk about the recent GTX 1080 Ti announcement by Nvidia. In this video, I'm going to be going through all the specs on Nvidia's new graphics card release and how it lines up with other graphics cards on the market. So let's go. According to Nvidia, the GeForce GTX 1080 Ti is Nvidia's new flagship gaming GPU based on the Nvidia Pascal architecture. The latest addition to the ultimate gaming platform, this card is packed with extreme gaming horsepower, next-gen 11 GB per second GDDR5X memory, and a massive 11 GB frame buffer. Now, spec-wise, it seems to be good enough to give you a fun gaming experience no matter what game you play, although there may just be a few exceptions. Its full spec list details that it has a GP102 GPU, a 1582 MHz boost clock, a 1480 MHz base clock, 3584 CUDA cores, 11 GB GDDR5X memory, 352-bit memory bus, 450W TDP or thermal design power, and it comes with a launch price of $699, which is considerably lower than its current big competitor, the Titan X, which comes in at $1,200. Nvidia has included Micron's latest GDDR5X memory with performance optimizations to allow it to run at a full 11 GB per second, giving the GTX 1080 Ti a massive memory bandwidth of 484 GB per second. The GTX 1080 Ti is also set up to run faster than the GP102 in the Titan X. Nvidia says that the 2 GHz overclock power GPU isn't going to be beyond the realms of possibility. As for this card being called the best Nvidia graphics card ever, Nvidia estimates that it ought to leave the GTX 1080 by around 35%, which they say makes it the best Ti card they've ever made. The 980 Ti leads by 25% compared to the 980, while the 780 Ti leads by 18% when compared to the 780. The GTX 1080 Ti Founders Edition will be the first card to drop, but the partners will be shipping their own versions with their own coolers shortly after launch. Nvidia also aren't restricting the Founders Edition to their own website, allowing their graphics card vendors to sell them too. Other editions of the 1080 Ti include the Asus GTX 1080 Ti, MSI GTX 1080 Ti, and the EVGA GTX 1080 Ti. I'll leave a few links down below so that you can check out the full list so far and get all the detailed features on these cards. So despite a lack of visible changes, Nvidia did say that there are some under-the-hood differences. The 1080 Ti vapor chamber is supposedly improved, providing either lower temperatures at the same noise level or less noise at the same temperature. So all in all, the GTX 1080 Ti is definitely a beast, and it's truly one of the best graphics card out to this day, especially at its price point. If you want a more in-depth analysis for the GTX 1080 Ti, then you can go to the description below and use the site links provided for more info. That's about it for this video, and if you liked it, be sure to leave a like, comment below about what you thought, and subscribe for new videos every single week. Also, you can check out previous videos using the links provided below, and that's it. Thanks for watching, and I'll be seeing you in the next video.